By midsummer, in duck waters everywhere, all the ducks have vanished. But they haven't flown away. You can still hear the unmistakable sound of 10,000 ducks chatting across the empty water. They're hiding, relying on the tall reeds for cover. All birds go through molt, replacing worn and tattered feathers with new ones. Usually, they replace flight feathers one at a time so they can continue to fly. But in a bold move, ducks drop all their flight feathers at once. They are temporarily grounded. Surrounded by plenty to eat, they don't need to take to the air. Yet, for the next 3 or 4 weeks, with no way to fly from danger, they are all sitting ducks. By late summer, when the molt is over, all the damaged, worn-out feathers have been replaced with strong, flexible new ones. And they are beautiful. Intricately patterned and shimmering with color. Some feathers are rich in dark pigments that help make them strong and resistant to wear and tear. But the most dazzling hues come from tiny crystals in the structure of the feather that scatter light in specific ways. It's nature's nanotechnology that makes the iridescent purples and blues and the brilliant greens that many ducks seem to favor. Staying bright and shiny usually starts with a bath. There's dust and dirt and parasites to deal with. Every feather must be combed out nice and flat, and then waterproofed. From a gland at the base of the tail, ducks spread a waxy ointment all over their plumage. The whole routine takes hours of nibbling and stroking and athletic contortions several times a day. It all concludes with a satisfying stretch, with every feather back in place.